Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God, you gave your Son to suffer death on the cross for our redemption, and by his glorious resurrection you delivered us from the power of death. Make us die every day to sin that we may live with him forever in the joy of the resurrection. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Hi, all you amazing children of God. I'm so glad you've joined us for worship today, for Easter Sunday. Happy Easter. We have this amazing God who can do all things. And God loves to do the unexpected. And this week, today, is the story of the unexpected. We left Jesus in the tomb, dead. And now we celebrate that Christ is risen indeed. And I have a song. I would like you to stand up. I know you're at home, but stretch those legs, because singing, we give all we've got to Jesus, just like when we waved the palms last week. Repeat after me. Ho, ho, ho. Hosanna. Ha, ha, hallelujah. He saved me. I've got the joy of the Lord. That's the song. Because we sing Hosanna, excited for Jesus entering Jerusalem. And then we sing Alleluia when we find that Jesus has been raised, because death did not win. Here's how it goes. Ho, 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 Hosanna. Ha, ha, hallelujah. He saved me. I've got the joy of the Lord. So will you sing it with me? And remember, we're ho-hoing and ha-haing with great joy, like we did on Palm Sunday. Ho, 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 Hosanna, ha, ha, hallelujah. He saved me. I've got the joy of the Lord. I hope you have the joy of the Lord. Pray with me. Hello, God. It is Easter. And we are so excited to see you've done the unexpected. You've risen Jesus from death. And you've promised us the same. Because death does not win. Thank you for that gift. Amen. Happy Easter, alleluia.
The first reading is from Acts. Peter began to speak to the people. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread through Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us, who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. We'll read Psalm 118 responsively. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my might. He has become my salvation. There are glad songs of victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I shall not die, but I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. The Lord has punished me severely, but he did not give me over to death. Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Our second reading is from 1 Corinthians. Now I would remind you, brothers and sisters, of the good news that I proclaimed to you, which you in turn received, in which you also stand, through which also you are being saved, if you hold firmly to the message that I proclaimed to you, unless you have come to believe in vain. For I handed on to you as of first importance what I in turn had received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12, then he appeared to more than 500 brothers and sisters at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have died. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one untimely born, he appeared also to me. For I am the least of the apostles, unfit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace toward me has not been in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we proclaim, and so you have come to believe.
Our gospel for this Easter Sunday comes from Mark, the 16th chapter. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, brought spices so that they might go and anoint Jesus' body. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. This is the gospel of our Lord. So I don't know what happens at your house when the end of a movie comes and the ending isn't quite what you expected. Often you can either hear Greg or me say, "Well, that was quite the ending." Well, what I just read is the end of the Gospel of Mark. It was so unsettling that some people have written a new ending to the book of Mark. But really, what I finished with today is where the gospel writer of Mark ended. Well, that's quite an ending, isn't it? This story of Jesus, this story of the end of 3 years ending this way, it's a little unsettling. It's like the story isn't over. Huh. Maybe that's the point. The story isn't over. These women go to the tomb of Jesus. They are distraught. Sabbath is over. And they are coming to the tomb on the first day of the week. They're coming there to do what they're supposed to do, to care for Jesus. And they knew that a big stone had been rolled in front of the gravesite of this tomb. And they were wondering, can we move that? And if we can't, who will do that? And when they come, they see that the stone has been rolled away. It's gone. They can walk in. And when they walk in, they see someone in there, sort of like in angelic pose. Some of you have heard me say, I don't want to be greeted by angels ever, because they always give you news that you're not expecting. And they always start with this phrase, or a phrase like it, don't be afraid, be not afraid. And here today we heard him say, don't be alarmed, don't be alarmed. But this story in Mark has this angelic person saying to Mary and to the other women, go and tell Jesus' disciples that he has gone ahead of them. He is waiting for you and the disciples in Galilee. Maybe that's the story of this resurrection in Mark. Maybe that's the point, is that Jesus always goes ahead of us. And Jesus always goes ahead of us to places we don't expect Jesus to go. In places where we don't expect Jesus to be. This is a different Easter this year. You know, last year, it wasn't that Easter was canceled. It was just that we had to celebrate it in a little different way. Part of our story from this point forward is going to be, remember Easter 2020. And maybe part of our story will be, and remember what it felt like to come back together in person Easter 2021. My question for you today is this. As part of our collective story, could you have written this year last year? Oh, we still are wearing masks, most of us. I don't in worship, to lead worship, but I wear my mask a lot. Some of us have shots in our arms, one or two. Some of us are waiting for that. And then we're told, but hold on, don't get ahead of yourself. That's kind of what this angelic body is saying to the women. Hold on, don't get ahead of yourself. Jesus goes ahead of you. That's what I want to say to all of us this year, this Easter. Hold on, don't get ahead of yourself, but Jesus goes before us. God always moves first. Doesn't get so far ahead of us that we are left behind in the dust, but goes ahead of us to prepare the way. Goes ahead of us to be welcoming when we do arrive. The hope of the Easter story and the promise of the Easter story is, it's about God. It's God's story. Some of you notice that I wear a bracelet. On the back of the charm, it says this, my story isn't over. My story isn't over. My story isn't over, and your story isn't over, because God's story isn't over. God's story goes on, and it includes you and it includes me. That's the hope that is left to us at the end of the story of Mark is that it's not over. And just like those movies or those books where you go, huh, that was quite an ending, it is left to your imagination how to wrap it up in a nice, neat way. Well, God's story isn't always wrapped up in a nice, neat way, other than this, that God never gives up on us. God's promise is true. God's story goes on, and it includes you and me. And because God's story isn't over, ours isn't either. The journey to the cross this year was different. It was different than last year, or the year before, or even the year before that. But the journey to the cross is real. And Jesus is real. And Jesus' story goes on and on, because God's story goes on and on. And because that is true, we have the hope and the promise that our story isn't over. So this day, we gather as God's people to say, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. The story isn't over. Amen.
Dwelt among men, my example is.
During our Lenten journey, we have been bold to confess our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed. We do that again together in boldness. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made. Of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. O Spirit that moves through us all during this pandemic, may you draw people closer to Christ and strengthen our relationship with God and church. Protect and guide YAGAMS, Young Adults in Global Mission, those who are out doing your work. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great.
Creator of all things, thank you for the warm days, changing seasons, singing birds, greening grass, and the geese who have returned to Oregon. Remind us to care for your creation as we see the garbage that is left behind from the melting snow. Help us to be mindful when disposing of our masks and gloves, and try to avoid using single-use plastics. Encourage companies that are working towards carbon-neutral presence, and help the animals that are living in the shelters find safe and loving homes. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great.
Peacemaker, guide leaders to make just and right decisions for all people and not be self-serving. Enlighten people to see each other as children of God and then treat them as such. Bring peace and comfort to people of color, Asian Americans, women, and anyone who is discriminated against due to something they can't control. Inspire us to find ways to eliminate the mass shootings. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great.
Healer, we look forward to the day when the vaccine is accessible to everyone, which will allow those who have endured the past year alone to enjoy friendships, and that health care is affordable and available to all people. We hope stimulus checks are helpful for families. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great.
Comforter, bring healing in mind and body to healthcare workers and other essential workers who are exhausted from this long year. May they know our appreciation and be renewed. Give wisdom and power to those who are speaking out and standing up for the oppressed. Help us hear you as you guide us towards new opportunities. We know you are with Rich, Sally, and Anna and their families. May your presence bring them peace. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great.
St. John's has undergone some big changes. Bring guidance as we continue to take steps to put action behind our words. Thank you for our interim pastor, Pastor Naomi, who is helping us through this transition. Continue to guide her and renew her. As the Oregon school districts and other districts' spring breaks end, ensure safe travels and good health for all those who are returning from their break. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Into your hands, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
For those of you at home worshiping with us today, I invite you to either get some bread and crackers or grape juice and wine so that you too can take part in this meal of Jesus. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb, who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all creatures, with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and living God, we praise you for creating the heavens and the earth. We bless you for bringing Noah and his family through the waters of the flood, for freeing your people Israel from the bonds of slavery, and for sending your Son to be our Redeemer. We give you thanks for Jesus, who, living among us, healed the sick, fed the hungry, and with a love stronger than death, gave his life for others. On the night before he died, our Lord and Savior took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his life-giving death and glorious resurrection, we await your promised life for all this dying world. Breathe your Spirit on us and on this bread and cup. Carry us in your arms from death to life, that we may live as your chosen ones, clothed in the righteousness of Christ. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your love and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us in the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. This is the Lord's table, and you are all welcome here, for the gifts of God are free. I invite you to take your bread or your crackers and know that this is the body of Christ given for you. And as you take your wine or your juice, know that this is the blood of Christ shed for you. And now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, give us strength and peace today and into your life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Wellspring of joy, through this meal you have put gladness in our hearts. Satisfy the hunger still around us and send us as joyful witnesses that your love may bring joy to the hearts of all people. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Before I do the benediction, just one announcement for all of you. Know that next Saturday, which is April 10th, we will be beginning having in-person worship at 5 o'clock. So if you would like to come and join us on Saturday evening at 5 o'clock, please do that. We would love to see you. We will also have worship on Sunday morning in person at 9 o'clock. We will continue our online worship as well, but know that you are welcome either on Saturday at 5 o'clock or Sunday at 9 a.m. And now until we meet again, receive this benediction. The Lord bless you and to keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Christ is risen!
He is risen indeed!
Christ is risen!
He is risen indeed!
Christ is risen!
He is risen indeed!
Jesus Christ is risen today!
Peace to love and serve our risen Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen.